All right, I got the GoPro set up. Hi there. And it's on my sculpting stand so that no matter where the sculpting stand is, you'll see the action going on in the one spot that I'm working on. And then I'll change the camera angle as I go on. But anyway, just wanted you to know how I got this set up. It's a great little camera. I'll take a picture of it and show you the setup. Okay, now what I'm going to do is try to work this flap that's sticking straight out, and I think I've got a photograph here someplace. Yeah, this one shows the flap, how it's sticking out, and it looks like a wedge, but it looks really cool from the angle of this front of the piece. Now, you see these little buttons right there? There's a seam that goes right down there, actually an opening, that you take the buttons, you unbutton it, and what happens is that opens up so that if you're wearing a sword on this side of your body, it will go through the coat without lifting up the tails. And so that's what I'm going to be sculpting right now in this area right here. Okay, this is the part of the support for my camera, so that's why that's there. All right, now I've got the upper flap, the one that comes down and up from the back. And now this flap here comes down and underneath there and is buttoned onto this flap. And it looks like there's one, two, and three buttons. So I'm going to mark that right there. I'm also going to straighten out that line once I get started here. But what I need to do is, because this flap goes underneath this flap, it has some stress areas for the cloth that I've got to sculpt in to make it look like it is underneath the coat. So I'll continue.
Okay, what I'm doing right now is I'm building up the jacket. Let me get this piece in here. Out, away from the leg a little bit, because I've got to have some volume in the jacket right here so that it looks like it's got volume from the front. I don't want it to be fitting tight to the skin because, quite honestly, there's clothing underneath this jacket. And there's a lot of material in the jacket. So I'm bringing it out away from the leg, bowing it out just a little bit. So it means adding a lot of clay on here. And it's already starting to pay off doing that, because the back view, and I know you can't see it yet, but you will at the end of today, it looks normal. It looks natural for this jacket to come away from the button that's going to be here. See, there's three buttons across his back of the jacket, too. And that all has an effect on how the cloth of the jacket hangs off of his body. And I just imagine a kind of a roundish volume in this area right here. So that's what I'm doing right now, is just layering off on big lumps of clay and trying to build up that volume. So anyway, the coat is starting to come into place, into shape, and I'm really happy with how it's turning out. The part that's going to be really hard is the technical part, and that technical part is the creation of the rifle for that period. Now, I've got books at home. I've got to start researching that, and that's what I'm going to do tomorrow. I'm going to be at home researching the gun, because I'm going to have to make that out of wood and wax. And that's got to be ready to go as soon as I start doing that left hand and arm that I removed. And I need to have that to go on the sculpture so I can work the coat into and around that. So tomorrow will be a no-sculpt day, and that's only because I got to get that research together, and I'm going to be working on my blog tonight, and then if I have time tonight, I'm going to start researching tonight, too. I've got emails from John Buxton back in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the historical artist that has been helping me all along on this. He sent me pictures of a gun for that period, I've got like I said from the book that he also recommended I get, which I did, and so now I just got to go through and draw out the plans for the gun. All right, everybody have a great night. Looking at the Madison Mountain Range, east, in the Madison Valley.